Hello everyone, welcome to a sequel to my pink and purple video. I have here some leftover Mars Black and I intend to not waste it. So I am going to scribe my usual circles. This time I will line them up like ducks in a row. And then have an elliptical shape. Right, that's it for the Mars Black layer. So I'm going to air dry this with my desk fan and then apply a second layer of a, I haven't decided yet what color, so I'll be back in a few minutes. Okay, these are somewhat dry. Now this is a gold acrylic paint pen and I'm going to apply some random lines. Since this is a brand new pen, it does write very well. It's very opaque. I thought the vertical lines will give some contrast. And texture. Okay. The good thing about these pens is you don't really need to wait too long for them to dry. They dry in about less than 5 minutes. So after that layer, I'm going to do a turquoise acrylic. Okay, and a phthalo blue. And the phthalo blue is on the edges. And now since this is a pint, I have to be aware that it's best not to use too much because a little goes a long way. So I'm going to start rolling the turquoise. And as you can see, the turquoise is semi-transparent. The same with the phthalo blue. They both have a lot of extenders. So I think the more expensive paints, the higher grade paints, have more pigment in them. So therefore are more costly to produce. Now this seems to be on the dry side. I'm going to need some more. And it's always better to put too little and then add than have too much. Okay, let's see how this works out. Again, I am using a sheet of Strathmore 400. And hopefully this will pull up the ghost print and the markers. Now, as a plan B, in case this doesn't work out, I can always remedy that by adding another layer of color and start all over. But we'll see how this works out. Okay, let's see what we have. It seems to have picked up. Thank you. interesting result. This time it looks like a spray or an aerosol. Here's a close up. So different brands of paint behave very differently, and it's best to experiment with each one to find out what works for you. Now, I will allow this to dry for a few minutes and then decide what the next step will be. So don't go away. Okay, back from a short break, I was able to assemble some of my reusable stencils. And since the initial layers are so highly textured, I want to counterbalance that with more of flat areas. So this is Naples Yellow. Okay, and I'm going to use cadmium red. This is going to be a very strong contrasting color. I'm going to start rolling out the Naples Yellow. Just trying to flatten out the areas of color. Make sure there are no high spots. I'm using the heel of my brayer to make these lines. Just tidy up the edges. So these are very clear cut, hard edge shapes to contrast with the very highly textured, powdery background. Hopefully I don't miss the stencils. Because once you forget them, they are a problem because they stick to the paper and it's hard to get them off. I think I have them all. make sure my fingers are clean. So here is the first layer. Now I'm pressing really hard because I want to get rid of those bald spots on especially the edges. And that's what happens when the paint is a little too thin and dries too quickly. That's difficult to control because the circumstances are different every time. Okay, I'm not going to leave this too long. So let's see what we have. Really nice contrast, I think. Yeah. Sure enough, I forgot a stencil. There we go. I think that's a very cool result. Don't you think? Now this is the effect of applying oil to the gel plate. It makes it a little resistant to the paint, so it creates these very interesting textures. I think this is a standalone print. It's just two layers, but it has enough going on. It has lines, it has textures, it has shapes, and contrasting colors, which are elements of a successful image. So anyway, I will air dry this and then recap. In the meantime, this is such a nice ghost print. I don't want it to go to waste. Okay, I will leave this for 5 minutes. Okay, it's been about 5 minutes, and as you can see, I don't know if you can see this on camera, the paper has really stuck on the plate because of the high moisture content of the paint. I just hope it doesn't tear. I think the result is quite painterly. It's pretty wild. Okay. I think this will benefit from another layer of a light color. So I will air dry this and then be back in a few minutes. I call this the gift that keeps giving. I'm not going to stop. I'm putting Naples yellow. And some copper. This should liven it up. It's almost gone. Now the lighter colors seem to have a better consistency. They're more creamy. They're easier to control. I find the acrylic is great for picking up ghost prints, but it's very thin. And it takes a little bit of getting used to. Really pressing hard because I want the leftover ghost print to transfer. Now, I'm not saying that more pressure means a better transfer. That's not always true. But I think it's better to apply enough pressure than to have not enough. So it's a combination of applying pressure and the time that the paper is left. Now I will experiment and leave this on for much longer, like 10 minutes. And hopefully it won't tear on me. Okay, it's been about over 10 minutes, and I enlisted the aid of my desk fan to help dry the paper. I don't know how helpful that is, but I think it is. I think the transfer is very, very successful. Because there's hardly any leftovers. Wow. Check this out. I think it does help. The fan helps dry out the paper and it helps it to pick up the paint more. So I will remember that next time I'm trying to pick up a ghost print. It's not just the length of time, it's the paper needs to dry enough that it has the strength to pull off the residue. So I will allow this to air dry and recap. Okay, here is the second ghost print, and I'm going to do an oil resist with red. And hopefully it will transfer. Since it has a bottom layer of oil, I think it will give readily. Let's see. Yep, and I don't even need to leave the paper on too long. I like that. Again, I will air dry this and then recap. Okay, everyone. This is the last leg of this video. And I thought I would have one final fling. I know many of you are going to say, why can't you leave that alone? But I just can't. I can't help it. So I'm going to do a final layer of an opaque yellow oxide. This is also opaque. This is Arctic by Lucas. So these are both opaque colors. And I want to counterbalance the busyness of the background of the second print. You'll see what I mean. It's easier when you see what I'm talking about instead of me explaining it in words. Okay, I think that is as even as I can. Now, hopefully, these clear-cut shapes will counterbalance the busy background. So this is the piece with the third layer. I'm just pressing along the edges because I want to have a clean edge. Okay, I'm going to leave this for 5 minutes. Okay, let's see what we got. This is exciting. Yep, I think I got what I wanted. Let me just press down a little bit on this edge here. I think that does the trick. It kind of quiets down the busy background. Okay, that is print number 3. I'm going to do backwards now. This is print number 2, which is an oil resist. The brushstroke textures are really emphasized by the oil resist. So that's print number two, and then we come to the first one. This one has the most clear-cut shapes. And I like the contrast between the busy parts and the quiet parts. I hope you liked this video. I had a lot of fun doing these prints for you. Thank you so much for watching and subscribing. And for those who can, I'd appreciate a little help with my PayPal to help keep this channel going. I hope to see you next time.